is... Oh, shit. This is my 2023 Formula D Pro Spec car. And it started life as a 1995 Nissan 240SX. Most common question that I get asked at all the events is, hey, how much does it cost to build a Formula D car? I mean, I've got an idea, but I've been kind of too scared to put it on a sheet. But today, me and you are gonna go through this car bit by bit and see what it costs to build one of these guys. Let's go. All right, we might as well just jump right into it. Let's get started on the motor, because that's what everyone always wants to see first. And there it is. Surprise, surprise, it's a Chevy LS motor. So this guy started as an LSX motor, more specifically a 376 LSX. So that's an iron block that's stronger on the bottom, high flowing heads, straight from GM, factory motor. But then that wasn't enough. We tore this whole thing down, sent it over to the guys at MTI Racing out in Atlanta. They fully built this and it should be able to support 800 to 1,000 horsepower pretty much all day. So how do we get there? Let's go through some of the parts that need to be put on a motor. I've spent hours on this Excel sheet. I hope you guys like this. So the crate engine alone, we're looking at around $11,000. To build this motor costs right around $15,000. That's to put all the good stuff on the inside, better bolts, hardware, pistons, rod, etc., right? Then you gotta let it breathe. You have your intake manifold that you need to put on there. That guy is $575. You gotta put headers on it because it's gotta exhale. Sticky headers, $595. Throttle body, 100 bucks. It's not too bad, actually. You wanna make sure that there's as little vibration through the motor as possible. So with that, a front engine damper from ATI, that guy, $455. With all the electronics powering this car, you need a high output alternator. So you gotta get one from DC Power, but you're gonna fork up $655. Well, you need spark, right? Coil packs, about 200 bucks. Spark plug wires, those are $165, which is way more than I thought I'd pay for spark plug wires. Then you've got your covers around those so that you keep as much heat away, 70 bucks. And then you need plugs, 40 bucks. There are a lot of odds and ends in between that I'm sure I kind of skipped over, but just for that, what I talked about, just for that is a little bit over $30,000. $30,379, and we haven't gone anywhere yet. Sick, you've got a sweet engine, but now you wanna crank some more power out of it. So we use a Vortex supercharger. So this is kind of some of the power adders that we have on here. So Vortex supercharger kit, 5,600 bucks. Then you're gonna need a blow off valve for that. That guy's $588. You gotta cool it all down. So we have a front mount intercooler from PWR, and this guy was custom, about $1,300. Then you got odds and ends, right? You got couplers, piping, etc. And that's about 250 bucks. Power adders alone, now you've racked up a bill of 7,742. All right, so now let's fuel this motor. To do that, we actually run E85.
Cold.
Pump E85. Honestly, there is better fuel out there, but dollar for dollar, it's been doing really well for us, and we test every batch of E85. So try that out if you're gonna do that. For fueling, we've got injector dynamics, 1300 cc injectors. There's 8 of them. That's gonna come out to 1873. That's $1,873. That's just injectors. This is really expensive. You're gonna need some, God damn it. You're gonna need some fuel rails for this guy. So we opted to go with Radium. They make a really nice set and it's all black, so I like the way it matches. That guy is gonna be 230 bucks. Not too bad. Then you need a fuel pressure regulator to regulate the pressure. That's from Radium as well, and that's 350 bucks. Now we gotta go to the back, because that's where even more fuel is held.
What's up, you guys?
We need a fuel tank. So we got a fuel cell back here from Radium, along with their fuel surge kit that just keeps all the fuel constantly flowing into the motor. Fuel cell, 919 bucks. For the surge tank kit, with all the pumps, etc., that you're gonna need in there, we're looking at 1390. Then you've got some fuel filters, obviously, so holds any contaminants away from the motor. That's gonna be 125 bucks. Then you've got the remote fueling kit, which is this guy right here, because you gotta put fuel in there somehow. That's 530 bucks. To install this thing, you're gonna need a cage. Radium also provides that, and it's gotta get welded in, so that'll be in the fab stuff. The cage alone, $530. When you're fueling it, you're gonna wanna make sure that the ethanol rating, or whatever fuel you're using, is always constant. That way you kind of know what's going on. With that, you have a fuel sensor. That sensor, $240. Fittings and lines will run you probably around $500. And then the fuel sender, which is basically telling you how much fuel is in there, $100. All in all, our fuel total, $6,856. The only thing you're really gonna see back here is gonna be the radiator itself. Everything else is underneath the car. You got lines, you got pumps, you got all that stuff. So not the sexiest of things to talk about, but honestly, it's one of the most important. On the grid, you'll sit for like an hour before you drive this car.
You're right.
And everywhere we drive happens to be blistering hot. So engine overheats, you lose power, all that good stuff. And honestly, I've had a lot of issues in the past with the cooling system, partially my fault because I kept cheaping out. And then finally this year, I really stepped it up and I got a PWR radiator along with their fan and shroud kit. And this guy's gonna go for $1,950. Then you've got your water pump in the front of the motor, $200. We run an electric water pump along with the mechanical. What we do is the mechanical pumps it to the radiator, the electric one sucks it out, sends it to the motor. That's from Stewart Electric, $480. Then you got dash 20 lines running front and back. Those get really expensive actually. AN lines, I think people forget about where that all racks up, but that alone is $1,100 roughly. And lastly, when water gets hot, it needs to expand, and for that, you need an expansion tank. So we got one from Canton, along with an overflow tank. It's built in, put together, it's really nice. Use it for a little bit, so I'm happy with it. That guy, $320. Let's lube this puppy up. Let's get all oily with it. You're gonna need an oil pan, and for that we use Sikki. Ours is a rear sump style, which is kind of cool because when you accelerate, oil naturally wants to go backwards, which is where that wants to go. And I'll show you why, because that has to do with the steering. That's a Sikki oil pan, and that's $756. You're gonna wanna cool this oil down. So again, PWR hooked this up. And we've got an oil cooler with their fan kit, and that's gonna go for $475. You need to relocate your oil filter. That is gonna go for $100. You got lines, fittings, etc. This is kind of a guesstimate. I'm probably undershooting it. $700 to plumb the whole thing. You want to relieve the crankcase pressure. With that, it's going to be an oil catch can. That's from Radium. That's hidden down over here. And for competition use, we have to use a really big one. I think it's 1 liter. It's a lot of oil, man. Just blowing. All right, so here's our oil pan. And like I was talking about earlier, it's a rear sump, which just means it goes to the back. Now, a lot of times for S14, it's a front sump, but because of the steering system that we use, we had to do a rear sump. I'll go through that in a little bit. Underneath the car is where I mounted the AccuSump system, and it's essentially a poor man's dry sump system. That basically is to keep pressure in the oiling system the whole time. That way there's no oil starvation. You don't wanna have any oil not be in the bearings because that's not a good time. That guy, $330. Then you gotta install it. They've got an install kit, which obviously we modified a little bit, $250. The total for all of the oiling stuff, $3,226. All right, let's wire this guy up. For that, the engine harness, AEM, $800. You're also gonna need to wire up all the body stuff, right? We're talking headlights, taillights, brake lights, all the little stuff in between. That one I got done by my buddy at Goon Racing Services. That is gonna go for $2,700. Then you've got your wideband sensors. Can't forget those guys. That's gonna be $615. After that, you got miscellaneous sensors and whatnot. That's gonna go for, I would estimate another $400 for all that kind of stuff. It's all wired up, so let's put a brain to this thing. And for that, we use a Link ECU, G4 Extreme ECU. On top of the ECU, we also use what's called a PDM, Power Distribution Module. Essentially, you're just getting rid of a lot of your fuses, and it's all controlled by a computer, which is pretty cool. All that works in conjunction with the keypad itself, so that'll control, you know, ignition, starting, stopping, our water pump, all the good stuff. To see all that info, we use a dash, and that's from AAM. And that's really cool because it's all in one place. It makes it nice and neat, and I really like the digital stuff, so it's really nice. Honestly, I think for next year, though, we're gonna do another Link product. I know Link, but it all works in conjunction so well together, and it's really, really clean, so kind of pumped on that. So to make sure that the AEM harness plays nice with the Link ECU, the guys over at Panic Wiring made me a custom jumper harness, which is really cool. That guy though, that's gonna run you $800. Link ECU, $1,750. Link keypad, $365. Each PDM is $900. We've got two of them, so $1,800 is our total. AEM dash, $1,600. Keep the juice in the car. We use the Optima Blue Top D31M battery. That is one of their largest batteries. And that's gonna go for $400. Total cost for all the electronic components, $11,230.
That's like 10 McChickens.
That's so many McChickens. All right, let's talk about the drivetrain, because you gotta send the power to the wheel somehow. We use a 4-speed dog box transmission. Really strong, holds a good amount of power. It's a T101 G-Force transmission. That guy, $5,000.
Jesus.
Right? But after you have the transmission, how are you gonna mount it up? So you need a bell housing. This one specifically has to have a blast shield rating so that if the clutch inside explodes, no shrapnel goes everywhere and cuts our legs off.
But you ain't got no legs, Lieutenant Dane.
So it's kind of important. That bell housing from QuickTime, $800. Inside that bell housing is gonna be a clutch. We use a twin disc ACT clutch to hold down all the power, $1,272. You're gonna need bolts to hold that puppy down. That's from ARP. That's not too bad, that's $35. So to engage the clutch, clutch master cylinder, that's from Sikki. That kit, $280. You need something to push the actual pressure plate. That we use a Tilton slave cylinder. That kit, $300. Now we travel down, you're gonna need a custom drive shaft. This guy we got from Driveshaft Pro locally. They're super cool. $600. Please follow me this way, Jacoby.
Bring the.
So that drive shaft goes all the way back to a quick change differential from Winner's Performance. And inside of this guy, we have an OS Geiken two-way clutch, which I really like personally a lot. Quick change, $3,500. OS Geiken differential, $2,000. To help protect the differential, you get a skid plate. I got mine from Blood Motorsports. And honestly, I'm pretty happy we got one because it looks kind of used. To hold up the differential in the back, Sikki actually has a service for you. So you could send in your OEM subframe, which is what we did. That subframe, $500. And their service is gonna be $1,680, so you can bolt in this Winner's Quick Change. So the last part of the puzzle for the drivetrain is gonna be the axles. Now these guys are supposed to handle at least 1,000 horsepower, and this is from WiseFab. And these are a full bolt-on affair for an S14, which is cool. If you notice, this whole car is actually completely bolt-in for the most part, so that's pretty rad. These rear axles, $1,880. Drivetrain's done, your total, $20,548. Car's got power, but it's gotta be put down somehow. Suspension's next. So for the front suspension, we use a WiseFab steering angle kit. This thing gets almost 70 degrees of lock, which is wild. But they also came out with a new one for a front rack system that utilizes a BMW steering rack. Pretty crazy. WiseFab front suspension kit, $2,750. Next up is the rack itself. That one you're gonna get for about $560 off the internet anywhere you kinda look. Then you're gonna need front hubs, obviously, to keep the wheels on. That's gonna go for $300. We use a electric power steering pump in this guy, which is really nice. It helps with less rotational mass on the motor itself. So just one less thing it's spinning. But for that, you're looking at $300. Next up is the lines and fittings for all that to be plumbed and put together, $400. And lastly, you're gonna need a front cross member to get modified so that that front rack steering can work, $350 for that one. Total front suspension cost, $4,660. So that was the front knuckle suspension kit. In the rear, same thing, WiseFab helps with a dual caliper setup, which is super cool. Does a lot of really neat things like anti-squat, and you could set it up and all this really cool stuff. But to have all that, $2,400. So now the suspension, all the springy stuff, the damper stuff, the stuff that you don't really see. We use Megan Racing's track coilover that's been revalved by the guys, and that's got a Swift spring on there as well to help be nice and linear in the recoil. That setup is gonna go for $1,350. You're gonna need a power brace in the front, and that's essentially where all the suspension links up to in the front. We use one from Power by Max. That's gonna be $1,320.
Happens to be wrong.
You're gonna need sway bars for this thing, and luckily, again, we got bolt-on options. Front, high clearance GK Tech front sway bar. And in the back, we got a Sikki rear sway bar that'll actually clear the Winner's Quick Change. GK Tech front sway bar, $328. Sikki rear, 400. Suspension total, 2398, which isn't too bad compared to all the other stuff. Yeah. Total cost for all the suspension, wheels and tires package, $17,000. $17,000. Dude, don't show this to my wife. All right, so now let's start talking about kind of the interior and the safety stuff. Inside, we've got a fire suppression system. That's $480. And that basically makes it so that you pull this little lever right here and it'll just shoot fire extinguisher everywhere in case of a fire. Try not to pull that. Need seats to sit in. This guy is a Sparco Circuit. That is $1,099. This is a Sparco Sprint. This guy, $450. You're gonna need rails to bolt these guys in. Each one is about $225, so $550. To get strapped in, harnesses, $750 for both of them. Well, you gotta turn the thing, so steering wheel. Nardi steering wheel, $350. Quick release, so you can pull the wheel off so you can get in and out pretty easily, $400. So if you're gonna be racing an FD, you're gonna need an FD legal cage. For that, this jungle gym around me cost me $3,500. Last part of the inside is our radio communication system, because you wanna be able to talk to your team, let them know if you're on fire or not.
Helmet top, Cruz!
Dude, it's so much more than you think. $2,800, let's get out of here. I'm out. All right, you got a car, but with no body panels, it wouldn't look very cool. So let's make it look good. Full kit from KBD, which includes your front bumper, side skirts, and your rear bumper. $1,200. Front fenders, I forgot how much they were. 75 millimeter wider, $500. Hood, $700. Pair of Koki lights from Spider, $350. Pair of corners, $50. Rear taillights from Spider also, $410. At least they don't ever see any damage.
Actually, so funny.
Rear fender replacement, 50 millimeters larger from Big Duck Club, $800. Big Duck Club rear trunk, $250. Rear Lexan glass, $200. Per FD rules, you have to have an LED strip on the top of rear for your brake lights, $50. The car's all kitted out. Now you gotta wrap it because you wanna make it look good. Rap Legends wrapped it for us, $4,500. All right, car's looking sick, and that only cost you $8,985. All right, so let's tie it all together. So on this, it's a little weird to price it because I did a lot of fabrication on this myself, but material cost is kind of what I'll go through. So I did a tubular front end and a tubular front bumper, and that all together, probably about $500 for materials. On the inside, we did something pretty unique as well for our transmission tunnel. We made it removable. We've also made it as big as possible for the Formula E rulebook, $850. With all the fabrication done, our total, $4,850. Last but not least, you need a car. So I bought this guy for $500. This thing was a bare shell. I literally dragged this thing onto an open trailer with some friends, and then I just sunk a ton of money into it. Grand finale. We've been going over prices all day. So, Jacoby, how much do you think it was?
I mean, a lot of the parts were quite up there.
Give me a number.
$135,000.
Okay, the total, good job. Almost spot on.
Are you
serious? $135,143.
It's not about money. It's about sending a message. Everything burns.
Pretty wild. So, there's tons of ways to build a Formula D car. Obviously, it could get way more expensive, and you could probably do it a little bit cheaper as well. There are parts on here that we upgraded only this year. But we've been running ProSpec since 2017. So all of that is just parts. None of it included labor. And labor is thousands and thousands of hours. But luckily, I love self-abuse.
I hurt myself today.
So I put myself through that. But if you were to whip out a credit card and just pay for it, just know you're gonna do just that. You're gonna pay for it. So I hope you liked this video, and you know what to do. Like and subscribe. Shoot all the comments you've got over and let me know. Did you like this video? Did I miss something? And let's talk. Other than that, let's see if we can make some more videos.